Ms. Maeve McLaughlin.
Good, Concorder, and I rise as a member of the Education Committee in opposition to both the motion and the amendment. And at risk that this debate today turns into whether a proposal is a proposal or a recommendation is a recommendation, let's be very clear again, as my colleague was earlier. The North Eastern Education and Library Board made no response whatsoever to this proposal. Two schools made comment on the proposal. However, as an authority, the North Eastern ELB made no such response. The Western Education and Library Board, despite what some members in this House said, made a recommendation, did not oppose the proposal. And their only comment, as has been pointed out, was in respect of a possible impact on existing English medium provision in Dungiven. So I ask the members of this House today, how can that be deferred to or referred to as a recommendation? And as has been stated, the body directed and charged with advising the Minister, Sina G, on these matters formally supported the proposal. The Ministerial Advice Group, which contained 33 recommendations, highlighted, yes, the expansion of preschool and primary levels with almost 3,600 children attending Irish medium primary schools and units. But yet it was still pointed up that there is a gap in the strategic development of Irish medium post-primary provision. The Department of Education, Ciarán Cóirleoir, has a statutory duty, and we know this, to encourage and facilitate the provision of Irish medium education. The Minister in this regard is simply living up to that statutory responsibility and duty. There is a gap in the strategic development of Irish medium post-primary provision. There are currently 29 Irish medium schools in the north of Ireland. There was a total, as has been stated earlier, of 5,000 people in Irish medium education in 2012-13. That includes 803 children attending Irish medium preschool settings, 3,061 primary school years 1 to 7, and 769 in post-primary. The development proposal proposes an all-ability, co-educational, multi-denominational Irish medium post-primary school catering for year 8 to 14 pupils, with a long-term enrolment of 350 to 400 range. The core argument here, Mr. Speaker, is that there is a demand for Irish medium primary provision for pupils attending Irish medium primary schools in County Derry, and the department has an obligation to meet that demand.
Would the member take a point?
I will do.
Boilam Arger Leha year are Rodatan Asnun Sean you Shin Kogarges less the Tish Mahori Augustina Dalti at Tabunchil College together. I think Mr. Speaker, and with thanks to the member for giving way, the one of the things missing is congratulating the parents, the organising committee. I know the author of the report is here today as well. For their courage and boldness and continuing to build for their future, for the future of their area, future of their community. And I want to say that, again, the negativity in this motion, the contrast I see in Irish schools, and I was in Bunscoil Fan Wadigan in North Belfast on Friday. I met young Nathan and Brendan May, twins of College of First, just starting College of First before Christmas, and I see an ebullience, I see a positivity, I see a joy, I see a desire and ambition to learn. And unfortunately, and I say especially to my colleague, Mr. Kinahan, we need to make sure that we don't send out the message to young people, to children in particular, this is an attack on them. These young children have so much to offer this society. They want to build for the future. They want to create a shared future. So maybe you'll take that on board.
Interventions are meant to be short.
And I thank the member for his intervention. And he is right to acknowledge the work from the organisations, the campaign and the local community and families in that area in taking this case to this point. And I do hope that as a result of this debate, we get the quality of education through Irish medium in the County Derry area that is very much required and needed. And I think it is important to stress that this particular proposal, and it has been documented, is optimal. It is easily accessible from all of the 5 identified feeder schools, and I think that's an important point. But it is critically important that the current arrangements, as we stand today, do not meet the obligations under the European Charter for Regional or Minority Languages and Article 89 in terms of a statutory responsibility. I oppose the motion and the amendment.
Thank you.